More and more, the ideas that generate organizations are political. Ideological competition is fierce. In the growing Jewish working class, socialism, in all its varieties, gains more and more support. It combines with different national visions. There are Torah socialists. There are Zionist socialists. There are communists. There are Bundists. The Bund is an anti-Zionist labor party that combines an affirmation of the Jewish diaspora with a socialist program.
Ideologically, I became a socialist when I turned 18. And after the first revolution, I decided that one cannot become politically active individually or in small groups. To become politically active, one must become a member of the party. When I joined the Bund, it was a revolutionary party. I met Heinrich in the Bundist student group at the university.
This student group at the university in St. Petersburg at the turn of the century, like other small groups of activists in East European universities, is, 20 years later, part of the leadership of a mass movement in Poland.
I came to Poland at the end of 1918. Poland, at the moment of gaining its independence and after the First World War, was a very poor country. And especially low was the economic level of the Jewish working masses. In Poland, the Bund really became a mass movement, a people's movement. And truly, a party of the working masses.
My name is Chaim Ellenbogen. I was born in Warsaw in 1915. I worked as a carpenter. I belonged to the Bund. And our hopes were socialist hopes. One of the main activities of the Bund was connected with trade unions. The unions were concerned with the welfare of their members. But at the same time, they took part in all political actions which the Bund initiated. The leadership of the unions were mostly Bundist, and many union members came through the unions to the Bund. This man organized those porters, and those people, some of them became very dedicated. Even they came from the rough and tough people, a lot of them were formerly underworld people, became dedicated, and they were the ones who usually went out when there was fighting to do. In many cases where people were evicted from their apartments for not paying rent. There were cases when police came and threw them out, and the Bundist militia came and put them back in their apartments. The activities of the Bund took in all aspects of life. There was amateur groups, theater groups, literary evenings. Another aspect of the movement was outings, organized to the ocean, in the mountains. There were libraries organized by the Bund. And Warsaw was called the Grosser Library. This library played a big role, I would say, in my own life, because not everybody could afford books. And through that library, we got acquainted with world literature. I remember as a boy, I used to read Roland, the French Barbie, German Toller, I recall. Russian literature, even Scandinavian, like Axel Munty, and so on. American was Upton Sinclair. And all those books were lent out from the library for minimal monthly.